also a teacher with one of the after-school programs, the year one program, year four. Taught for 3 years, and my students, in the spring semester, they get to do a mural, and this time I decided to like have them help design the mural. So in the summer, when they work on a professional project, I was like, what if our class was a professional project? Let's not just do like a little mural inside the school, let's try and make this whole project a budget big enough where we can do something that's really cool, really big. So this is all stained glass, cut stained glass in mirror. So everything's small little pieces, I don't know if you have any detail shots. And it's all, they help design it, and moving. This is a mural at Arlington High School. I worked with the mural arts group again, where students kind of came up with poems, ideas, worked with all different folks. It actually has a whole other side to it, with birds, kind of this flock of birds, just goes along the entire side. It's just huge, huge. It's the most recent mural. It depicts the cliffs that are right behind the art museum. This is the gateway to Fairmount Park. All the rocks are done in charcoal. I work with a friend of mine, a collaborator, it's like a wash of paint over the top. So it's kind of like that gateway into the museum area. So this is the wall. On rubber. Incredibly awesome. Very excited to work on. I mean, it houses everything. And like, as we talk about this, we have like the past, present, future. This still houses it. It started as a rubber factory, is a rubber factory, and will be, you know, and so like, even as you walk through like the machinery, everything is still kind of original. Like, I mean, it's kind of impressive and beautiful. So this is the wall. I'm going to show you a couple details of the actual places, because this is some of the stuff that I'm thinking about. It's really challenging. It's not just one huge wall that you're going to totally transform, which is kind of a little bit more of a shock. This is like little bits and pieces that are going to kind of almost be dictated in some way by the history of the building, which is just gorgeous. The brick, the old signage, you know, I'm not going to touch that, but here's like some of the parts that I'm thinking about and which will be painted. There's these little window spots that have been like center blocked up as you're standing there waiting for the train. Those are little sections. So it's almost pedestrian in a way. The next wall is to the right of this main wall, this little highlighted area. Furnace area, and it's a big wall, but it also has this funky conductor thing in here with wires. I mean, there's challenges that I'm thinking about how to like incorporate, how to use, how to respect what's already there and just build upon it. The next section, you can kind of see the purple or like reddish little highlight runs along the fence. It's huge. I mean, it just keeps going. It's like 300 plus feet. This is a huge wall. It's also